My name is Jake Burkhart, and I am 24 years old, and I am a second-year PhD student at the University of Missouri Columbia. My area of study is ecology. Specifically, I'm interested in landscape genetics. Besides school, I really like hiking, and so I found any excuse to get outside, running around in the woods, and that's ultimately why I am going into ecology. Because I find it fun to run around in the woods, and so if I can get paid for doing it at least some of the time, why not try? I started out my undergrad wanting to be a doctor, and then my freshman biology professor sat down with me during office hours, and he asked me, are you sure you want to be a doctor? Like, what are your hobbies? And so I told him that I liked running around outside, like being active. As a child, I really liked looking for just whatever I could find. We went snake hunting, we went hunting for salamanders, and I hunted. And he just looked at me and he said, you're not going to be a doctor, at least not a medical one. And so I started doing research with him my second semester of my freshman year and fell in love with population genetics and haven't looked back since.
Burkhart discusses what his lab is all about.
What we're looking at is just basic life history of salamanders, and so we're looking at what influences salamander populations. And so if we're looking at it from a trophic level perspective, do more predators influence the number of salamanders that are coming out of a pond, and what other factors within the ponds might influence the number of animals coming out?
Okay. Do you think that your studies could have any human applications?
Mine do. Since I'm going into landscape genetics, what I'm ultimately interested in is looking at the influence of humans on how habitat change and alteration influences the distribution of natural populations. And so, like, habitat fragmentation and degradation has a lot of impact on amphibians. And so they're declining globally, and so since we're altering the landscape at alarming rates, we need to start mediating that.
Burkhart performs fieldwork at Fort Leonard Wood, a military base in Missouri.
Since I work on a military base, there's a lot of things that I never thought I would get used to. When I first showed up, I was out in a pond, and you think you're in the middle of nowhere, and then all of a sudden you'll see people in camo walking by, or you'll hear gunfire in the background. And sometimes you hear explosions as well, because it's an active training facility. And so when I first got there, I was always thinking, like, I'm never going to get used to this noise. But towards the end of working down there, I started realizing that as I didn't notice the noise as much as I noticed the silence. And so on weekends when they weren't training, I would just be like, man, it's a quiet day on base today. A lot of times, like, when I'm out in the field, it's just really cool to see what's going on. And so when I'm doing field work, a lot of the times I'm not just collecting my data, but I'm also, like, collecting mushrooms that I can eat for dinner later, or I'm taking pictures of different organisms that I might not be directly studying, but I see.
What other careers did you seriously consider, and what convinced you to do research?
So I had considered going into medical professions. So I was considering being a doctor or physical therapy. But ultimately, I realized that I wouldn't be happy in an office all day. And I don't really like set working hours. And so when I found research, I realized that there are so many questions that can be answered. And I really liked trying to investigate a problem and thinking about it. And the fact that if I do ecological research, I can go out into the field and get data, get outside, but then come back to the lab and do my data analysis and then sit at a computer and try to figure out what's going on.
What obstacles have you faced getting where you are now?
Being younger in a PhD program, there's a lot of internal pressure to try to work harder. And prove that I know what I'm doing. But at the same time, I feel like part of research is being willing and able to ask questions. And so regardless of where you're at in your career, and regardless of what your age is, you're going to be successful if you are willing to accept help and know how to ask for it. I always encourage people, if you're interested in something, just try to do an internship or volunteer, because you never know if you're going to like something until you try it, and it never hurts to try new things.
What is your dream job and why?
I really like the one-on-one mentoring relationships where you're able to share your passion with other people and answer their questions and help them get to a point of understanding with something that you're knowledgeable on. And I also really like being out in the field. And so if I can maximize that, that would be my ideal job.
Burkhart discusses his favorite part of the research process.
The most satisfying thing to me is at the end of the research project. And so you've spent so much time collecting this data and thinking about it and trying to figure out what's going on. And then when you get to that point where you're able to see a pattern emerge, or when you get your data outputs and all of a sudden you're just like, whoa, that's not what I expected at all, and you're able to see the end product, that's really, really satisfying to me.